My name is Gal, and I used to be a natural scientist, and I was dealing with electroactive bacteria that can produce electricity and clean wastewater at the same time. And basically, these are bacteria that can transfer their metabolic electrons to an electrode on the way to oxygen. So basically, if you put a wire between this bacteria and the oxygen that they need to respire, they basically can just use this wire as a conduit for the electrons, thus creating electric current. The idea with this project is to have a plant at the top that produces sugars, and the plant emits the sugars when they're in excess. It emits them to the water, and here we have some mud that I got from a lake, from Teufelsee. And in this mud live this kind of bacteria that can produce electricity. And we have an anode and a cathode that are made of activated carbon. In this case, we used also some graphite supports, just out of you know, the stuff that you put into a pencil. They are, graphite and carbon are actually electrically conductive, and so the idea is that the bacteria will eat the sugar produced by the plant and send the electrons via these wires here. So this is coming out of the bottom through this resistor, which is just 1k ohm, and up here to where these electrons can reduce oxygen and create water. We built two different prototypes yesterday. This is actually my second prototype, and this is the third one. The first one I did here for a few months ago with stainless steel electrodes. It didn't work so well because they rusted. So hopefully this time it works a bit better. Here we have just the activated carbon, and here we have the activated carbon with graphite support. And as you can see, this one is already producing some potential. These ones are still not producing any potential, but it's a process. It can take maybe a month, maybe even a couple of months until it reaches its full potential, which would then be half a volt for each plant pot. And these are my lovely assistants, by the way. Richard, who helped create these two beauties, and Alessandro, who helped create these two beauties. And we've named them after revolutionaries. So we have Karl Marx and Rosa Luxemburg here, and we have Karl Liebknecht and Rosa Parks here. And so, I don't know, may the best revolutionary win.